Well, in the future, I would like to see flying cars.
The wheels, like, go out like this and you just fly.
We could create something that a lot of people need that would bring us all together.
I would like to invent a kind of medicine that would stop the disease.
I do know in developing countries, water is really, really hard to get.
Okay, I think a good invention for the future would be a giant atmospheric filter that kind of covered the globe.
And you could add in random boosters to skateboards and bikes that would make you go faster.
Phones that have holograms, because that sounds pretty cool.
Engineering is, I don't really know, but I think just making things for the better.
You find things made by engineers everywhere. If you look around, everything you see, your car, your toaster, your shoes, your house.
The building you go to school in, there was a civil engineer involved in that. The computers that we play on, there was a mechanical engineer, an electrical engineer.
Paint, you name it, anything. Toilet paper, shampoo, food products.
Engineering is all around you.
Engineers are everywhere.
Everywhere.
I think it would take somebody with a really powerful growth mindset to accomplish things like this.
Because, you know, you can't just think about it. You have to actually think about it, you know, because those things are really hard to think about.
You have to be really smart. You also have to be really creative.
You would need to have problem-solving skills.
It's just a matter of having a little curiosity and the drive to do something to help the world. I think sometimes we can be stereotyped as you have to be nerdy, or you have to be a boy, or you have to look a certain way, and I don't think that's true. I think anyone can be an engineer. A good engineer is able to come up with creative solutions to problems. They communicate with a lot of people of different fields and just working in teams.
You have to have the thirst for knowledge. You have to always want to learn.
Anything science related, so biology, chemistry,
calculus, physics.
You absolutely do not have to be a math whiz to study engineering.
I think you have to be able to understand basic concepts of it, but I don't think you have to be some genius to be an engineer.
Engineers will always be in demand. That's one of the reasons why I chose engineering, because you will always need engineers to help you solve the next generation's problems.
Engineering gives you so many opportunities. There's so many different disciplines you can get into.
I can't think of another profession that has the flexibility that engineers have and the type of work that they can do on a day-to-day basis and on a career-long basis, different areas that you can get involved with.
It's incredible to think about what we can do as engineers to impact the world.
I became an engineer because I want to help people and I want to improve people's lives.
You can build anything, you can make anything, you can solve real-world problems.
Our society can't advance without that innovation in the technology fields.
I knew I wanted to be a positive contributor to society.
I love the challenge.
There's always something to improve upon. Nothing's perfect.
You're helping people, you're changing lives, you're, in some ways, you're saving lives, right?
more robots everywhere, like helping in hospitals and helping people like on the street.
One day in the future, I would like to build lenses because some people are blind and they can't really see anything, so they're missing out on a lot of beautiful things to see on this Earth.
I'd invent a machine that could take you to Jupiter and let you explore other parts of the galaxy.
It would just be really cool to be able to teleport places. And that's what engineering is.
Yes, I can picture myself being an engineer.